evening and welcome back to round two of the Sim Racing Online Touring Car Championship Season 1. We are at Birmingham Motorplex tonight and we've had two of the races. And so far it's been a clean sweep for Mr. Farrow, two pole positions, two race wins. And it is now time for race three, which is the reversed top 10. So that is going to put Mr. Brook on pole and Farrow on 10th. So this is an opportunity for Ericsson to try and claw back the points lost in the opening two races. So Farrow will currently be the new championship leader. But normally race three provides excitement as the fastest drivers are in the middle of the pack. So we have just over a minute to go for warm up. And we will go again for another 15-minute race. Standing start, no formation lap, and it should be 15 minutes of action if the last two races are anything to go by. I have a feeling that Mr. Brook will be a little bit nervous sitting on pole position. As I've already mentioned a couple of times tonight, Tim hasn't practiced, only just synced the mod and joined warm up with seconds to spare, so hopefully he doesn't bottle it off the line and can hold a few people up for a while. So we'll wait and see what happens. A few people out of place because of incidents that happened in race two, so Nilsson will be quite high up and so too will Gary Lennon. So good opportunity I think for Gary Lennon to maybe one of the favorites of this race, but Nilsson will have something to say about that. We've seen it's quite a difficult place to overtake. We've seen most of the overtakes happen when there's been mistakes in front of them. So with just 5 seconds to spare until we go to race, I hope you enjoy it. As we look at the broadcast car there, also my racing car, but sadly that won't be leaving the garage in this one. There's Mr. Ruskus, third and a second to him today. As we go to the race, there is Mr. Brook. Starting second will be Nilsson. Third will be Sousa, Reed in 4th, Lennon 5th, Foley 6th, Stenbeck 7th, Ericsson 8th, Ruskus 9th, Farrow 10th, Motoram 11th, Soboleski 12th, Simmons 13th, Moraes 14th, Weeks 15th. So we should be getting the lights any second now. And so we see Brook is on pole. Let's see if we can get a camera shot again. As they all lead the line, the lights go out. And it looks like a poor start by Brook. Nilsson's taking the opportunity. Looks like everyone's got away okay. So they head down into turn one. And Brook under pressure there. I think that's from Lennon. A few people running out wide. I think everyone's done okay there. Here we go. Awesome shot there. People are three wide. That's Wayne Reed, I think, down there on the grass. Manages to hold on to it. So Nilsson leads Lennon. Oh, Tim Brook back up the inside. Someone takes a curb off there. So they all fly through. Looks like Foley challenging for third spot down the inside. He makes contact with Lennon, and Lennon's off. I believe that's him rejoining there. So they've gone, and I believe that's Stenbeck. Scheller Stenbeck has had a spin there. See if we can get him there. Yep, oh no, it's Sergio Sousa who's spun, so he's all the way down to 17th. So, perfect start for Nilsson. Brook loses one spot down to second. Foley up to third after that contact. Maybe it wasn't Lennon because it's showing Lennon in fourth, so maybe I had my drivers mixed up there. I apologise for that. Haven't got the best quality stream here that I'm looking at, as it looks like he is going side by side. That's Foley going down the inside into turn one. Runs a bit deep, some contact there, nothing too heavy, gets the job done. So Foley up to second, Tim Brook is third, fourth place is Lennon, fifth place is Matt Farrow, so great start from him. 10th to 5th, 5 positions on one lap. A great start for him. Looking at the back of Lennon. thinking about a move down the inside. Is going to be close enough as they lock up ahead. Sixth place, a little bit back is Ericsson. So his opportunity to try and keep Farrow behind has failed. And he's got a train of cars behind him. We see they seem to be getting through okay. Back at the front, Nilsson is pulling out a lead. Who's that pulling off the track? Need some sort of incident there. If we can find who that was. I think that might be. Someone was pulled off the track there, but it doesn't appear. Who is this? That looks like Sergio Souza, who was struggling to get out of the way and make it back to the pits. So let's get back to the action. As we see, Nilsson leads. He's under pressure from Foley, so hasn't managed to pull away. Foley, great opportunity here as he's got some cars in between him and Farrow, who is still in fifth, hasn't made any progress, and that's Lennon going out wide. So Farrow moves up to fourth. So the new fifth place man is Gary Lennon. Tim Brooke shouldn't be too much of an obstacle for Farrow. Obviously, these two both driving Pro 5 Motorsport. I don't think Tim will hold him up too much. We'll drive too defensively, and another mistake. As I said, that's the way to make the passes today. As Tim Brooke drops down to fourth, so in two, three laps, Nilsson, Brooke has gone from first to fourth spot as we see Mark Foley set the fastest lap of the race. Well, I am expecting that to be beaten. They should get into the fours like they did in race one and race two. But Farrow up to third, perfect start from him. Fifth place man Ericsson looked like he's pushing Brooke through the corner as there's some contact there. As we go back, we lost Brooke. Here he is, spinning around. See if we can get a replay of that. Right on board, as he looks like he is side by side with someone. And he just loses the back end, but was he pushed? Let's see. I think there was some contact there. As that looks like Ericsson thinks about the inside, that's one hit there, send him sideways. Yeah, that's definitely not a mistake by Brooke, but he was here to be barged through the corner by Ericsson. Meanwhile, let's get back to the action at the front. Race is still being led. Sorry, back to taking off number lock. Here we are. Back at the front, Anders Nilsson is. I believe that was just a bug. That scared me there for a second. Went back to the pits. He is under pressure now from Mark Foley. Let's see what Foley can do. The top three managed to build a bit of a gap. So it's Nilsson, Foley, Farrow in third. Fourth is Gary Lennon. Ericsson behind him in fifth. Sixth place is Jeffrey Ruskus. Seventh is Jordan Weeks. Eighth is Sobolewski. It's a good start from him. Didn't benefit from the reverse grid, so he's made up quite a few places. Ninth place is Mohammed Patel. Tenth place is Dwayne Reed. 11th is Tim Brooke, obviously being moved out of the way earlier on in the race, so lost a load of positions here. So disaster for him on his opportunity to shine. It looks like he was using all the track and a bit more there. Dave Simmons in 12th. 13th is Scheller Stenbeck, so something has happened to Scheller. He's dropped way down. 14th is Mario Moraes, and 15th is Jonathan Motteram, who's DNF'd. There are a few DNFs here. Bradley Vanian is 16th DNF. And 17th is Sergio Souza in the pits for the 2-minute stop, so that is pretty die-hard attitude there. Wants to make it to the end. That's 9 minutes to go. So here they are, the leaders side by side. It looks like Foley's going to try and get the job done around the outside under braking. Nilsson a bit later on the brakes. Great driving and respect shown there by those two drivers. And this has worked perfectly for Mr. Farrow. Look at that gap back to fourth as Ericsson looks like he's got past Lennon, I believe that was. Meanwhile, Farrow running wide out on the grass. Let's see what Mr. Farrow sees and why he is faster. As he closes it up a bit there, taking a different line to the two in front of him. And you see he loses time on the entrance. That seems to get get it back on the exits, obviously taking the different approach to the other drivers. So Foley thought about a move down there, as it takes a lot of curve into T1. But Jordan Weeks sets the fastest lap again, 104.6. I believe Weeks is down in 7th. Let's get standings up for you. And Farrow still not able to get past, but only inches behind. Thinks about a move up the inside. And Mark Foley, I think he fell asleep there, as they're going to go side by side. And Farrow just gets the job done before the corner. But Foley definitely asleep there. And that's Nilsson. Sideways. Massive slide. And he's hold on to it. Excellent drive from Nilsson. He's lost two positions, but he hasn't damaged the car. We've got to have a replay of that as Farrow goes up to the lead. Let's get on board with Nilsson as he heads into this corner. Okay there. Catches a bit of a bump. Loses the back end on the grass. Massive tank slap and manages to hold on to. Excellent driving there from Nilsson as we go back to the action. So it's Farrow from Foley, from Nilsson. What can Foley do? I don't think there'll be too many people sitting here thinking, oh, and Farrow's gone wide. And Nilsson seems to be pushing Foley on. I don't think Foley got the drive off the corner, though, to challenge him, but he's so close. Let's ride on board with Foley. Is he going to think about a move down the inside? Is he close enough? I don't think he is, as Farrow misses the apex a bit. This is where Foley made the mistake before and didn't stay tight enough on the last lap. That's where Farrow got through. So in one lap, Farrow goes from third, as Foley stays in second. But Nilsson is the biggest loser, although he's held on to him. Nilsson's using so much of the track again, pushing so hard, it's losing time from running out that wide in that corner. Once again, we see Foley taking a different line to Farrow. But looks like he might have an opportunity here. He's not getting dropped. Like he might be finding the form that he had on R-Factor quite a few years ago. Doesn't race it as much anymore, but was a very, very quick driver a couple of years ago. So, could he throw a spanner in the works here? Everyone would have their money on Farrow doing the hat trick. But Foley, so far, being equal to it. Let's have a look back to the order. Fourth place is Ericsson. As you saw earlier, he got past Lennon. And Lennon is still in fifth. Sixth place is Jordan Weeks, who did set the fastest lap, I believe. Well, that should be a good battle to monitor. Ruskus in 7th, obviously struggled with the reverse grid. He went all the way back down to 9th on the grid, I believe. So he's only made a couple of positions and not made the progress of Ericsson and Farrow up at the front. In 8th place is Hamid Patel, pretty much by himself. 10th is Wayne Reed, I accidentally missed out. 9th place man of Tim Brooks. So what has happened to Mr. Sobolewski? Dave Simmons is 11th. 12th is Sobolewski, and it looks like he was making contact with someone there. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. We ride on board with Sobolewski. Who's that in front of him? That is Dave Simmons. So coming up to the car chicane. I don't think there wasn't any contact. I don't think Dave Simmons just lost it. Seen so many drivers lose it on that corner, and that's Stenbeck behind Sobolewski. So Stenbeck is 12th, 13th Dave Simmons obviously from that spin, 14th is Mario Moraes, and Jonathan Motorham is 15th. Did Sergio Sousa make it out of the pits? No, he didn't. So that's a DNF for Sergio. Back at the front with some lapped traffic there. Barrow's got, looks like he's made a tenth or two break, so I think this is pretty much race signed, sealed and delivered to Mr. Farrow for the win, as we've got 4 minutes to go, so it's going to be about three or four laps in these last 4 minutes. Foley should be good for second place. Nilsson, I don't think he's got the pace to challenge him, although anything can happen in these Toyotas, as it looks like Nilsson got a good drive out of that corner, and it's not being dropped. And who was that in the background? I don't know if that was lag on the server, but that's someone spinning about. That was a ridiculous thing. Who is this? I believe it is Jordan Weeks. know if that was lag. It must have been lag. Oh, no, it must be a disconnection. And as we see his car go back to the future. So, oh no, it wasn't a disconnection. It looks like he's still going. Maybe his screen minimized or something, but that was a strange one. Well, he's back and running. So, some more bad luck for Mr. Weeks. We seem to be saying that far too much. Seems to be the unluckiest man in sim racing. Paris hits the fastest lap, 8:104.4. That's blistering pace for Mr. Farrow. Foley still in second, Nilsson in third for Team GTK. Fourth is Ericsson. I think he will be disappointed with tonight's performance. He's going to have lost his championship lead, and Farrow's going to be points ahead now with these three race wins if it continues like this. Fifth is Gary Lennon. Sixth is Jeffrey Ruskin, so he's moved up a spot since we last saw him. Wayne Reed is in seventh. Eighth place is Mohammed Patel, who has, it's not Shella Stenbeck's car. Up in there. See if we can get number, there we go, there is Mr. Stenbeck's car. So a bit of traffic in front of them, that is Mario Moraes. Just about gets out of the way. So Stenbeck will be looking for a last 2 minute push to try and get an extra position from Patel. 10th place is Dave Simmons, 11th is Jordan Weeks, who's making a pit stop after that damage, so he's going to lose loads of places. Sobolewski's out. And what has happened to Sobolewski? It's a DNF. I don't think the replay's going to get it, as I'm trying to find it as we look through the replay. I don't think we're going to get it. Oh, there we are, and it looks like he has just popped on the track. Not good there from Sobolewski. 8, night 2, forget, as we see if there's some battles going on. Foley looks to be under control, 4 seconds. Gap at about a second. Although down to 7/10, and Nilsson with a strong middle sector there. Battle for 4th, this could be some entertainment here, although I would expect Ericsson to be able to hold off Lennon, but these 3 are. One of the fastest drivers on track, as Lennon looked like he had a tank slapper there. And again, let's look back on Ruskus. This has got to be an opportunity for Ruskus. He goes for the inside. Here he comes. Is he going to get him on the brakes? He's going to be on the inside for this corner. He's going to, yeah, he gets the job done. Otherwise, if he'd left Lennon a bit more room, Lennon would then have the inside for the second corner. So we see the long right-hander, but excellent driving there from Ruskus. And that puts Ruskus up to 5th. With not enough time, I think, to catch Ericsson in front. So where is Matt Farrow on track? This will be the last lap then, with 10 seconds to go. What can Nilsson do? Is he close enough? He is close, but is it close enough to make a move? As Foley looks like he's a bit out of shape there. Didn't appear to lose too much time. And we see Matt Farrow going into the second to last corner. It's going to be a hat-trick of wins. Is Nilsson, he's thinking, he's taking the Foley, goes on the defensive. Is he going to get the cut back? He's going for the outside. It's right on board. He's going to get the run. Foley's closing in, and Farrow's taking the win. And I do not know who has got that. It's another photo finish, as we're going to see in 4th. I believe that was Ericsson. An utter madness again at the finish of the SRO Touring Car race here at round 2, race 3 of the SRO Touring Car Championship. Who got it? It was Foley. I believe that was 0.004 of a second. So, ridiculous finish there once again. As that's Wayne Reed doing a celebratory spin, and Stenbeck doing a drift. Once again, mad finish in the Sim Racing Online Touring Car Championship. So I will confirm to you the finishing order. Right now, as the drivers come across the line, Farrow, hat-trick of wins, dominant, and takes the championship lead. Mark Foley in second, Anders Nilsson third. Andreas Ericsson, once again, disappointing finish for him there, fourth. Jeffrey Ruskus in fifth, Gary Lennon sixth, Wayne Reed seventh, Sheila Stenbeck is 8th. 9th place is Mohammed Patel. Dave Simmons is 10th. Mario Moraes 11th. Jordan Weeks 12th. After some bad luck, Sobolewski, first of the DNFs, in 13th. Tim Brook 14th. Jonathan Motteram 15th. Bradley Vanian in 16th. Sergio Sousa in 17th. And I believe that is that for today's racing. And I don't think anyone's going to pop up quick enough. I need to go for a drink. So I hope you enjoyed the broadcast. I hope we can have someone more lively and energetic doing the commentary next time. I have tried my best to keep you entertained. And I hope you enjoyed the show. So join us next week for round three. Track to be confirmed in my head. It is on the calendar, but I don't know it to tell it to you right now. But it will be next week, and it will be broadcast once again live for free on SimRace TV. So we will see you all next week.